Hello, my name is Natalia Makarova. I am a ballerina and I have danced many ballets with music by Tchaikovsky. The music that goes with the story I'm going to tell you is also by Tchaikovsky and is played for you on the piano by my friend Karel Rosenberger. Tchaikovsky was Russian, as I am. And when you think of Russia, you think, of course, of snow and ice. That's true. For where I was born, in Leningrad, it would get so cold in the winter that when I went outside, my eyelashes would freeze. The story that I will tell you is about the Snow Queen who comes from far, far north in the land of ice and snow. Most people never see her, but when it is snowing very hard outside, she may be there, whirling among the snowflakes, dressed all in white and riding in a white sleigh. This story is about someone who did see the Snow Queen, and this is how it happened. Long, long ago, when trolls and hobgoblins still lived upon the earth, there was one more evil than all the others. He was a wicked hobgoblin who loved to make fun of people. So he invented a mirror that made everything that was beautiful and good look strange and horrible. In the beginning, the trolls only played with the mirror, holding it up to the world and laughing at their reflections. But one day the hobgoblin flew up into the sky with it, and the mirror spun out of his hands. Down it fell to earth, down, 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 shattering into millions and millions of pieces. Some were as tiny as grains of sand, and when the wind came, it blew the pieces all over the earth. If one of these pieces blew into a person's eye, everything became distorted, and nothing ever looked right again. But it was even worse when one of these slivers entered someone's heart. That was terrible, because their hearts froze like lumps of ice. Then, in the coldest days of winter, the Snow Queen might come for them. When the Snow Queen chooses a child whose heart has been turned to a lump of ice, she comes riding in her white sleigh, dressed in glittering white snow crystals. She's an enchantress. And so great is her icy beauty that the child she has chosen to live in her ice palace forgets all about family and friends back at home. At a time when the tiniest fragments of the hobgoblin's mirror were still swirling through the air, a boy and girl lived right next door to each other in a big town. The girl's name was Gerda, and the boy's name was Kai. They were best friends and loved each other very much. In the summer, they loved to play in the little rose gardens which were outside the windows between their houses. Thank you. In the winter, when the windows were tightly closed and covered with ice, the two children heated copper coins on the stove and pressed them to the frosty windows. This way, they made small, perfect peepholes. Then Gerda and Kai could look at each other across the garden. Late one wintry night, as Kai was getting ready for bed, he went to the window and looked out through the peephole. Snowflakes were falling softly, and as Kai watched, the snowflakes began to pile up, getting bigger and bigger, until they took on the shape of a woman, a beautiful woman. She was so beautiful that Kai couldn't take his eyes away. Her dress was made of millions of starry flakes, but she was all ice, glittering ice. Her eyes shone like two bright stars, but they were cold and piercing. She took Kai's breath away. She nodded and waved her hand, beckoning to Kai. Kai was excited, but frightened, and jumped back from the window. Just at that moment, a shadow passed the window as if a giant bird had flown by. When he looked again, the beautiful woman was gone. Soon the snow melted and the earth grew green. Once again the roses bloomed and the children were able to sit outside. One day Gerda and Kai were looking at a picture book of birds and animals when suddenly Kai cried out. "What is it?" asked Gerda. "Oh, something sharp got in my eye," Kai exclaimed. And then he gasped again. "Oh, something just pricked my heart." It was one of those tiny grains from the wicked hobgoblin's mirror. Remember the mirror that distorted everything and that had shattered into millions and millions of slivers? A tiny grain of it had gone straight to Kai's heart and would soon turn it to a lump of ice. Poor Kai. Gerda looked into Kai's eyes. There was nothing to be seen. He blinked his eye, but Gerda couldn't see the tiny grain of mirror. She put her arms around him and cried because she felt so sorry for him. "I think it's gone now," said Kai. But he was wrong. Suddenly, he turned on Gerda and began to make fun of her. "Why are you crying? You look ugly when you cry." "That rose up there has a worm in it," he shouted. He pulled off the rose and stamped on it.
"What are you doing, Kai?" Gerda cried. She was frightened to see him so changed.
And when he saw how frightened she was, he pulled off another flower and marched off, leaving Gerda all alone. Kai was not like himself anymore. He did not want to play with Gerda. He would imitate and make fun of everyone in the street. One winter day, when snow was falling, Kai went down to the square in the center of the town, where the older boys were hitching their sleds to the back of the farm wagons for a longer ride. While they were sledding, a big white sleigh pulled by white horses suddenly appeared in the square, as if by magic. The sleigh was glittering with eyes that looked like diamonds, and all of the boys stopped and stared as the sleigh circled the square twice. Kai felt strangely drawn to the sleigh, and to show off to the other boys, he quickly tied his little sled on behind it. The horses' feet seemed scarcely to touch the ground as off they went, faster and faster. Soon the town was far behind them, and Kai began to feel frightened. He couldn't see who was inside the sleigh. He tried to untie his sled, but it was no use. He seemed to be stuck to the big white sleigh, as if a magnet were pulling him. Snowflakes swirled around them, and the sled moved like the wind. Then the sleigh stopped. And who should get out but the Snow Queen herself, the same coldly beautiful woman he had seen through the window. Her skin was almost transparent, like ice, and she was dressed all in white furs from head to toe. "You look so cold," she said. "Come closer and let me put my fur around you." She wrapped Kai in her furs and kissed his forehead. He shivered. Her kiss was colder than ice. It felt as if she were made of ice. Her kiss went straight to his heart, which was already half ice. But after a while, he no longer felt the cold. The Snow Queen kissed him again. And then he forgot all about Gerda and the others at home, his parents and grandmother. "Now, my dear Kai," said the Snow Queen, "I will take you to my palace. You will see how beautiful it is." And they set out again. This time, Kai rode by her side, and she no longer looked cold and icy to him. As they flew over woods and lakes, over oceans and islands, all the way to the Snow Queen's Ice Palace. Back at home, everyone was worried about Kai. As time passed, the neighbors began to say that Kai must have drowned in the river that ran close to the town. But Gerda could not believe this. One morning, very early, Gerda put on her new red shoes, her favorite possessions. She kissed her grandmother, who was still asleep, and went down to ask the river about Kai. Thank you.
Is it true that you have taken my friend? She asked the river. I will give you my red shoes if you will bring him back to me again. She climbed into a rowboat, which lay in the tall grass by the water, took off her new red shoes, and threw them as far as she could into the river. But the boat was not tied securely, and floated away from the river bank, carried along by the swift current. At first Gerda was afraid, but then she thought, perhaps the river is taking me to my Kai. After a while she came to a big cherry garden. In the middle of the garden there was a little house with red and blue windows. An old woman came out and pulled the boat in to shore. She gave Gerda cherries, and Gerda told her all about Kai. Then the old woman said, come, my dear girl, I will make you feel better. Let me comb your hair with my golden comb. Was magic, and it made Gerda forget about Kai for the time being. For you see, the woman was a witch, but she was not a bad witch. She just wanted a little girl to keep her company for a while. But one day Gerda saw some roses, and that reminded her of the rose garden, and then she thought again of Kai. Oh, she said, I have been delayed. I should have been looking for Kai. Do you know where he is? She asked the flowers. Do you think he is dead? The flowers all told her their own stories, but they did not know where Kai was. And so Gerda set on her way again. After a while, she saw a crow flying overhead. Have you seen my friend, Kai? She called to the crow.
Perhaps, said the crow. There is a castle not far from here, and the princess who lives there has just married a young stranger who seems to be afraid of nothing.
That must be Kai, Gerda cried.
Follow me,
said the crow and flew off. When Gerda and the crow reached the palace, and when she first saw the prince coming toward her, she thought it was Kai. But as the prince and princess came closer, she saw that it was not Kai, and her heart sank. The princess and her prince saw how sad Gerda was, and listened to her story. They invited her to stay there for the night. The next day, they gave her some boots to replace her red shoes and some new clothes. And to Gerda's surprise, they sent for their golden coach to take her on her way. Thank you.
But soon the coach came to a dark wood. All of a sudden, it was surrounded by robbers who seemed to be threatening her. The coachman ran away, and Gerda felt very afraid and alone. But just then, a little gypsy girl ran out of the woods and threw herself between Gerda and the robbers. "Leave her alone!" the brave little gypsy girl screamed. "She will be my friend and play with me." The little gypsy girl took Gerda with her to where she slept and kept her pigeons and her reindeer. The gypsy girl made the pigeons flap their wings, which made a loud noise, and Gerda was afraid to go to sleep in this strange room. After the gypsy girl was asleep, Gerda lay awake and listened to the pigeons.
"Quoo, quoo, quoo, we have seen Kai," they said. "He was sitting in the Snow Queen's sleigh. Coo, coo, coo. The sleigh was floating low over the trees. Coo." "Where was the Snow Queen going?" asked Gerda. "Coo, coo. Perhaps to the Snow Queen's palace. Coo," they replied.
In the morning, Gerda told the gypsy girl what the pigeons had said. The gypsy girl asked the reindeer, "Do you know where the Snow Queen's palace is?"
"I can take you far north to the land of ice and snow," the reindeer answered. "I was born and grew up there."
So the little gypsy girl told the reindeer to take Gerda far north to look for Kai. She tied some food onto the reindeer's back for the journey. As Gerda and the gypsy girl waved goodbye, the reindeer, with Gerda on his back, darted off over briars and bushes through the big wood, over swamps and plains, as fast as he could go. After a long time, they saw orange-colored lights up in the sky.
"There are the northern lights," said the reindeer. "They will show us the way to the land of ice and snow."
At last they came to Finnmark, and the reindeer said,
"I know a hut where the wise old woman lives. Maybe she can help us."
Gerda was so cold she couldn't speak, but the reindeer told the old woman Gerda's story.
"Oh, you poor creatures," the wise old woman said. "You've got a long way to go yet."
Thank you.
It was hot inside. So Gerda took off her boots and mittens. The wise old woman took the reindeer off to one side and whispered to him.
Kai is with the Snow Queen. He thinks it is the best place in the world. But that's because he has ice in his heart and a grain of mirror in his eye.
The slivers will have to come out before he can be human again. Otherwise, the Snow Queen will keep him in her power.
But can't you give Gerda a magic potion which will give her power to conquer the Snow Queen?
Asked the reindeer.
No. No one can give her greater power than she already has, replied the wise old woman.
Don't you see how everyone wants to help her?
Her power is in her heart, because she's so good and kind.
If she can't reach the Snow Queen herself, then we can't help her.
You can take her as far as the Snow Queen's gardens.
Put her down by the big bush covered with red berries.
From there,
she must go on alone.
Gerda and the reindeer flew off so fast that Gerda forgot her boots and mittens. It got colder and colder as they flew along. Finally, they reached the red berry bush in the Snow Queen's gardens, just as the wise old woman had described. The reindeer put her down and kissed her. Tears were streaming down his face. He could hardly bear to leave her here alone. But the wise old woman had told him he must.
Gerda put her arms around his neck and then set off. He watched her go, without shoes or gloves, in the middle of freezing, ice-bound Finnmark.
She ran forward as fast as she could. A whole army of snowflakes came towards her. As they advanced, they got bigger and bigger and looked like monsters coming to attack. Gerda said a prayer, and it was so cold that her breath froze as it came out of her mouth. It grew thicker and thicker till it formed itself into an army of bright little ice creatures. They pierced the snowflake monsters in front of her with their icicle spears, and Gerda walked bravely through the snowflakes.
Gerda hardly felt how cold it was, but walked quickly on to the palace of the Snow Queen.
Suddenly, there it was, towering above her, an enormous palace made of icebergs and snowdrifts, all glittering white.
Thank you.
could hardly see the top. She went through the frozen gate into the palace and saw no one. Just huge corridors leading off in all directions. Everything was ice. She ran through one enormous empty room after another. Where was Kai? Where was the Snow Queen? The room stretched on and on for miles and miles. Room, larger than all of the others, with a frozen lake in the middle of it. There, in the center of the frozen lake, was a beautiful throne made of ice. She couldn't see that on the other side of the throne sat Kai. The Snow Queen had left him there by himself while she went off to drop snow on the warm countries. Kai sat there, moving pieces of ice around, like someone in a trance. The Snow Queen could safely leave Kai there by himself because he was under her spell. He could hear the Snow Queen's words over and over in his head. You must form these pieces of ice into the world forever, she had said. Only then will you be free. What Kai didn't know was that as long as his heart was a lump of ice, he would never be able to spell the word forever, and therefore he would remain in the Snow Queen's power. Kai looked at the pieces of ice and thought, he sat so stiff and still that he looked frozen. As Gerda walked around the throne, she suddenly saw Kai. He did not even look up. She rushed to him and threw her arms around his frozen body. Kai, dear Kai, she cried. Have I found you at last? She shed hot tears which fell on his chest and penetrated to his heart. They melted the lump of ice there and melted the sliver of mirror which was in it. Only then did he recognize her. Gerda, dear Gerda, is it really you? Where have you been for so long? And where have I been? Why is it so cold and empty here? As he looked around the icy palace, Kai burst into tears. He cried and cried until his tears washed the piece of mirror from his eye. Then he held on to Gerda as if he would never let her go.
Their happiness was so great that even the pieces of ice danced for joy around them. When the pieces settled down, they had formed themselves into the world Kai had been trying to make. Forever. The very world that would set him free. Gerda kissed Kai's cheeks, and they grew rosy. She kissed his eyes, and they became bright like hers. She hugged him, and he became well and strong. Suddenly, there was the swoosh of the Snow Queen's sleigh. She was back. Kai, she called to him, don't leave me. But there on the frozen lake, she saw the world forever. She had lost her power over him. His heart was no longer a lump of ice. Gerda and Kai, holding hands, ran down the miles of icy corridors, out of the Snow Queen's palace, into the warm sunshine. Wherever they went, the sun broke through the clouds. When they reached the red berry bush, they found a reindeer waiting for them. I'm so happy for you, he said. Let me take you back to the forest. On the way, they stopped at the wise old woman's hut to thank her for her help. Then the reindeer took them back to the forest, to the gypsy girl's camp. Goodbye, he said. I will remember you always. Then out of the forest came Gerda's friend, the little gypsy girl. They hugged each other and danced and danced and jumped for joy around the campfire. Then the gypsy girl took hold of their hands, and the three young people pledged their friendship. It was time to be on their way. Kai and Gerda walked on, hand in hand, and wherever they went, they found spring and blooming flowers. Soon they came to the big town where they lived. They went straight on to grandmother's door, up the stairs and into her room, where they found grandmother sitting in her favorite chair.
Everything was just as they had left it. But as Kai and Gerda went through the door into grandmother's room, the room seemed smaller to them, and they realized that they had grown up. Kai and Gerda sat down close to each other, happily holding hands. There was a beautiful cluster of roses at the open window. It was a warm spring day, and the icy cold of the Snow Queen's palace was far, far away, like a bad dream. And in the garden, the birds were singing a joyful song of springtime.